YouTube.
Collapsed the first tooth.
Now, what you looking for?
A black and red tiny file.
Bow.
It was sticking out of here. If you ever have to use a file without a handle, this thing will go right through your wrist, right through the palm of your hand. So use it in reverse pulling. Step doesn't actually have to take a thread, it has to take a washer. And I do not believe the burr is big enough to interfere now. Long thing came out, spring out. In. Washer, spring. Close enough for rock and roll. Out. Two drops of Loctite Red. If you didn't catch that, I'm not doing it over. It'll screw things up.
Yep.
Okay, so In a couple of hours, we will take this in the house and run a couple of tomatoes through the machine and see if it still works. Okay, so now this thing goes together with this thing, and I'm sure they all have names, but to me they're all Bill, George, and Fred.
Fred's outside.
That's in the way. Okay, that goes like that. That. I don't have enough hands. Okay, and then this goes like that. Tomatoes go in here. Seeds and skins come out here. The pulp comes out there. Give me a cloth. So basically, and it needs to be plugged in. Who would have thought?
Gravity works.
What?
So gravity works.
Now I have shown doing this in previous videos. So I did not get the two tapped holes completely concentric, but for this doesn't really matter. This should last another, 10 years?
Yeah.
So, I'm gonna call that a success.
No grapes?
No grapes, no more. Okay, so it's about a week since I finished fixing the this thing. And about 5 days since we shot the closing of the video. And I thought, well, there's something I want to point out. So we might as well show how all of this goes together in case you're planning on buying this strainer thing. So, meat grinder portion, fat end, has to stick through as far as it will go. And it goes into here, do up the little knob on the side.
The unicorn corkscrew?
The unicorn corkscrew. I'm a unicorn! Time for cosplay!
Oh, you're a silly old man.
Now, the small square goes inside the unicorn horn. The nut that generally usually holds the grinder blades in place holds the strainer assembly. The shield that directs the tomato sauce down into the bowl. And the tomato skins and seeds and that little woody part that grows down from the stem into mature tomatoes all winds up in here.
Tomato turds.
Now, recording. See. Why do these electrical appliances always have to be plugged in?
Because you're special, and you have a habit of not plugging them in before you need them. That's so fun. Kind of black.
Now, that corkscrew is 3/4 of an inch from the back wall of the feed tube. So when you're pushing tomatoes down, or in the case of what broke it the last time, grapes down, stuff is jamming up behind the unicorn horn, and that unicorn horn cannot go any further back or it will not engage with this screen. So if anybody from KitchenAid is watching, redesign the unicorn horn to be a little longer, please. So anyway, this is our fourth bushel of tomatoes to run through this since it was repaired. So the repair is holding. The
house.
The problem that caused the problem seems to be the design of that tapered spiral screw. It should be fully behind that feed tube like it is when you're grinding meat. Anyway, this is just an addendum since I haven't finished editing the 10 months worth of video. So that's it for now, and thanks for watching. With my love